People who quit a job in the heat of the moment. What *t show did you leave them to handle? Didn't get a bonus because they felt the overtime I did paid me more than the bonus they gave to everyone else. I didn't know what to say to that, so after a few hours I offered to get coffee for everyone. Then I left and never came back or contacted them again. I keep thinking that I should go back with coffee now I've been gone 10 years and just act normal. Or when I was a programmer at an insurance company, one of the longtime programmers had been with the company for nearly 20 years. This guy originally wrote most of the financial system himself, from scratch, and had maintained it with the help of a couple of other people. Every month he did the month-end processing, and every quarter he did the quarter-end processing. Every year-end. Yep, it was him. This year there was a change in management a couple of times, and he kept getting treated worse and worse. He was being treated unfairly, asked to do unreasonably more work than he was already doing, getting thrown under the bus, that kind of thing. He finally had enough, and one morning he came in, walked to the manager's office and quit, then walked out the door. In the aftermath, it took a team of four other people months and months to get things back together and to a point where things were serviceable. I got stabbed in the shoulder while working as a bookmaker, betting shop manager. I was the only key holder, and while the paramedics were tending to me, the area manager was on the phone asking me to open the store the next day. I closed shop for the day, came back once I got out of hospital, put my keys in the safe and left my notice on the desk. Store didn't open for 3 days while they sorted a field manager, 18 years old, assistant manager at a big pizza franchise, had been working open to close for 2 weeks straight because the new GM went on vacation right after taking over the store. When she got back from her vacation, she worked a half day. I opened and still closed. Then she changed the schedule and took 2 days off. This was the last straw on top of a ton of other garbage piled over a year. Multiple new GMs, garbage TE district manager, awful store politics. I was alone during an unusually large lunch rush and was just done with everyone's garbage. I had a mainline full of orders, phones ringing, oven full of pizza, orders to be picked up, and a massive batch of dough sitting on the prep table. I said fluff it. I shut the oven off, walked out, and locked the store. Didn't call anyone to let them know. It would be hours before the evening driver would roll in. No prep for the day. No dough for the day except for dal blob. I am sure would become a massive mess after rising for hours. A double-deck oven with both belts full of pies wasted, and what was probably shaping to be a $1,200 lunch out the window. I hope she was well rested after her time off. Worked for a landscape company doing new installs. Our owner was cheap with a bad habit of constantly biting off more than he could chew. 1 year he asked if we wanted any part of a school project in a city we didn't live in, over 2 hours away, and we said no. He said that was fine and would just bid on one school for his crew who lived in that area. Instead, he bid on multiple schools and got three of them this year. Obviously, none of us are happy about this, and he claimed that he'd put us up in hotels so we wouldn't have to commute. He never did. The work itself sucked. Way more than a crew our size could handle, and the owner's brother did absolutely nothing. He was supposed to be the project manager, supervisor, and literally all he did was play Clash of Clans on his phone and yell about people not being fast enough. After a few days, I was done. I'd grown sick of the job anyway, but this project really sealed it. Having to commute 4+ hours a day and then physically destroy myself was taking a toll fast. I woke up Friday morning, called the owner, told him I quit and to stop taking more work than he can manage. He blew up, but I just hung up the phone and went back to sleep. 2 weeks later, I get a call from him. He's begging me to come back because after I quit, two other guys did too. The project is now woefully behind schedule and he's going to get fined if things don't pick up and get finished. I told him he should have thought of that before he bit off more than he could chew and expected a small crew to do it all in a short time frame. He got quiet and then asked if a 50-cent raise would get me back. Ha ha ha, no. Last time I ever heard from him, and I can't find his company website anymore. Shoppers fucking Drug Mart. I had simply asked for better hours after working ridiculous late night hours for over a year. Instead, they hired a new guy and gave him the exact hours I asked for, and then had me train him a year. So when training wasn't going very well because new guy was super slow, they blamed me for it. Now I had a good standing with everyone at this store, but I didn't need shoppers, and I let a lot of garbage slide every day. So again, when I asked for a vacation that I deserved because I was never sick and punctual as all hell, I was denied it, and the next day the manager had 4 weeks of vacation set. So to make it up to me, they offered me all these insane overtime shifts for the next 3 weeks, so I waited for the frozen deliveries to arrive that same day. The boss was packing up to go home, and when he said good night to me, I said, "But who is going to do this frozen delivery?" Quote. He laughed and said, "You are," so I replied, "Nope," and he became super cross, so I started laughing. "What are you laughing about?" he says. So I said, "Fuck yourself. I quit." Now there was no one to finish the night shift. He immediately asks for the uniform, lol, nah. I said, "Fluff yourself. I quit." I had never done that before or since. Uniform went in the trash. That always worked the close shift at a fast food joint. My managers love to hand out citations for any little thing. The policy was 3 strikes and you're out. I had 2 strikes left and was told to clean up the entire front end and bathroom in an hour or risk getting a 3rd strike. To put things in perspective, I had to close the register, count the money, clean up the front end, restock everything, sweep and mop the floors, and clean the entire bathroom, including the toilets. For basically $8.05, I walked into the bathroom just to see what to expect. Looked like someone had finished projectile garbage eating all over the toilet and then decided to piss next to the sink. I knew I wouldn't be able to do everything in an hour and that I would get fired regardless. So, I took my uniform off and walked home shirtless. Worked as the engineer at the mill. Was responsible for operation and process adjustment of certain piece of equipment. Made it works with better than specified results. But my managers required more production, less power, etc. So, at the point machine reached its back quote's capacity, and further pushing was risky and huge amount of invest was needed. I was told by brass that UDIDN back quote to even try to do it. Only say some lame excuses. I was full of this garbage and called to the manufacturer of this equipment. Long story short, instead of instructions and advices, they sent me a job offer for local service rep after I quit the mill. My ex-colleagues tried to push machine above the limits and successfully broke it and stopped the production for a couple of weeks. I worked as a small engine repair tech for a larger company. I am also in the National Guard. I had gotten hurt and needed physical therapy, and 1 or 2 days a month I would have to miss because of an extended drill weekend. Well, my boss didn't like that and she decided that she would punish me by making me stay later than everyone else. She was punishing me for going to physical therapy for a workplace injury and for being a soldier. Now, you may be thinking, having to stay late to keep up on your work doesn't sound like that much of a punishment. Normally, you would be right, but trust me, she was doing a lot more to make sure it was a punishment. Well, one day after being told that I was not given approval for the 1 day of vacation I asked for, 3 months in advance to go see the eclipse and generally being treated like a slave, I was like, why am I doing this to myself? And clocked out at the end of my shift. That next Monday after drill weekend, I showed up, packed up all my tools and took off. My boss started freaking out when she saw what I was doing. I left and found out that me leaving cost her over $100,000 because she had to ship my workload to another state to get another shop to work on themes here. That meant she needed to pay to ship them, and then pay to ship them back, and since her shop didn't do any of the actual work, she never saw any money for any of the repairs. It was over 80 riding mowers.